Welcome to part two of Low Budget Let's Check Out Lethal Weapon for the NES. This is Ron Moore along with the Wiiguy and Starsoldier.
Woo!
Oh yeah, baby. We're hitting the movies.
Yep.
Or the game is hitting the movies.
Yeah.
Or we're all getting hit.
The game is the movie.
Yeah. Alright, let's go watch Lethal Weapon.
Look how they're holding the guns.
Yeah.
Right out to their chin, practically.
This is how we hold guns, right up to our pecs.
Oh, there's the female predators.
It looks like they're breakdancing.
No, some of them are moonwalking with the guns. It's like, oh yeah, we're cool.
Yeah, really.
Do 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 do.
Welcome to Michael Jackson's Moonwalker for the NES. That don't look
Wait,
like
they're stealing stuff. Get them.
Yeah. That don't look like Michael Jackson.
Well, hey, at least they ain't stealing bikes.
Come on, the car looks like Freddie Jackson.
Say what?
No, nothing.
Collie Jackson?
No, I said, don't look like Michael Jackson. What, like coming out of the car look like Freddie Jackson?
Oh, okay.
Don't laugh, it ain't funny.
But
Alright, what's Paul now? He's kind of too old for this, but he's doing pretty good.
Still got grenade throwing skills.
Yeah.
As what happened in the movie.
Playing this game really makes me want to go back and watch part one right now and part two.
It's almost like the movie is a lot better than the game.
Oh yeah.
Well, this is based off the third one, or it's at least the cover art is and such, so I don't know if that, if you have to see that one too.
Where's yeah. Joe Pesci?
Yeah, I know.
Whatever Joe Pesci? Whatever it's just got a whole lot of racist in here.
Yeah.
What, you think I'm funny? You think I'm some kind of clown?
But, you're black. What was his name in the movie? Joe Pesci, I forgot his character's name.
Joe Pesci.
Marv. Wait.
Was it Marv? No,
I'm thinking Home Alone, and I think that was Daniel's character, I think.
Yeah.
Was it Harry? It was Marv and Harry. I forget who was who.
Yeah.
How could I forget that? It was one of my favorite movies.
The Sticky Bandits.
Anybody remember Gone Fishing?
No.
I also had Danny Glover and Joe Pesci in it.
Yeah. See, we're running out of commentary already, because there's not much to say about the game. Like, really, I mean, even Korshak didn't know what to say. He's like, you have to pardon me, but making commentary, there's not much to do here.
Well, you see, this game was developed by Eurocom, who also developed some pretty good games like Magician and James Bond Jr., as well as Ferrari Girl. No.
And this is not one of their better ones.
And the holes in the ground were made by man. Also, the green dumpsters in the background, and watch out for the bricks.
Don't be a prick.
Yeah.
Don't be a prick and prick up the brick, or pick up the brick.
The walls in the background resemble a ghoul school when it glitches.
And I always hate that too. Why couldn't this be a two-player game?
Yeah, I don't even know what it is.
You have to go off screen.
Eurocom never made two-player games. Yeah. Just single-player experiences Eurocom does.
Oh, great.
What's the NES? It's so limited.
Just like Double Dragon 2. Oh, wait.
Yeah.
And River City Ransom. Oh,
yeah, wait. Mighty Final Fight.
That was only one player, though.
Yeah, but it had more moves.
Yeah.
Gameplay.
Oh yeah, and that was actually fun.
And Target Renegade, wait.
Woo! Aw! You were just making a joke out of that.
Oh yeah, it's a huge joke.
Yeah.
I think this is better than Target Renegade.
Let's troll Wiiguy, part one.
Well, I can agree. I can see why.
Whoa, what the?
Whoa! I know
the... Oh, look out. It's Dr. D. David Schultz.
I think he's holding the gun then properly, too.
I think wrestling's fake. What? You think it's fake? Is it fake? Does that feel fake, huh? What?
He looks more like John Swagger.
John Swagger, who's that?
Yeah.
Points of reference? level 2, stage 2. The Gardens.
Is John Swagger like John McCain?
It's Harvest Moon.
Wait, Jack Swagger or John Swagger?
I was thinking John Swagger.
Oh, okay.
Uh-huh. You know, the racist guy?
Yeah, with Uncle Zeb or...
Perfect for Mel Gibson.
Whatever his name is, yeah. Alright.
Oh, Mel.
Oh, bulletproof vest.
Well, would that help with grenades?
Oh, wait a second. I guess not. Oh, man. Well, it's a bulletproof vest, not a grenade-proof vest.
Exactly.
Dang it.
Why are there holes in the ground? What are they, gophers?
It's Groundhog Day when this game came out.
really?
Yeah. You know that?
No!
How could you not know that?
I don't know!
Okay, that makes sense.
I don't know either.
Yeah, Jan Jackson's are back.
And Chris Tucker as well.
Yep. I'll look out. Man, what?
Yeah, oh, don't touch that Black Man's radio!
This ain't Target Renegade, get out of here. Ah, dang it. It reminds me every 2 seconds I'm done.
Ronnie, you're dying.
You know, at least Ninja Turtles 1, the beeping stops. Zelda and Lethal Weapon can learn from that.
The two prominent examples of that thing. Zelda and Lethal Weapon. You wouldn't hear that.
Yeah, really. And for that reason alone, Ninja Turtles is a better game than Zelda. I'm just kidding. Okay, now Heather and Ninja Truth are going to flag my video now.
Oh, they wouldn't be like that. Or would they?
They did before. That's because I got in a fight with Ninja Truth in real life and beat him up and they got mad and... I'm just kidding.
Damn right. I don't want to hear that. It's mean. You're Ronnie. You're Rommel. You're not like that.
Yeah, really. Oh, ECW. Oh, wait a minute. Well, I'll tell you what's not ECW. Me about to die. Look out. Game over. Wait, it says I'm retired? More like deceased.
Actually, you're closed.
Oh, yeah. No, the case is closed. And how about your mouth be closed after that because this commentary is over?
Oh, snap.
And now for a quick let's discuss. This is my first time playing the game. I don't know about you two, but...
What, that's it? You're not going to finish it?
No, it's just a less checkout.
Oh, does less checkout mean you go till you die?
I guess so, yeah. It's not a full playthrough or review, so I mean...
Well, since it was a budget, kind of like low budget reviews, I would have thought. But,
it's just a quick checkout thing.
I think there are only 4 levels anyway.
Yeah. But anyway, yeah, I mean, so far the game is not that good. Pretty good soundtrack, though. The game would have been much better if they had more variety of moves, like in a Final Fight, Double Dragon. I mean, yeah, it would have been almost like a Streets of Rage for the NES, the way it looked, if they had done a better job executing it. Graphics are pretty good, and controls are okay, just wish it had more, variety of moves and gameplay. So, I mean, it's kind of bland so far. I mean, I don't know, I'm going to have to give it maybe a 4.5 out of 10. Wiiguy?
All right. Yeah, as I said in part one, I don't own this game, so I haven't really, played and beaten it. I did play it, on emulator once, and I did like it. I really would like to then own the card and beat it and, thoroughly enjoy it from that. And, of course, being this was developed by Eurocom, you got some pretty good graphics, some pretty detailed graphics with, of course, an awesome soundtrack by Neil Baldwin. And,
Alec Baldwin.
Yeah, exactly. And I don't care much about it, being, a Lethal Weapon game. It's, tag any movie, it's still going to probably be hated on or whatever. Or just criticized. But I could see it as like a, nice beat-up, like Target Renegade. I like Target Renegade, so I'm pretty sure I would like this game as well. I'm pretty sure I'd be good at it too, so... Yeah, I would probably get this game about a 6 out of 10.
Alright, Starsoldier!
Okay, so there's so much wasted potential here that I see. yeah, they were trying to go for a decent beat-em-up. Each, Mel Gibson, Dank Lever, they have, cool moves. Dank Lever can throw Brits. Mel Gibson can jump higher and do drop kicks. And it seems like it was almost there to be in a good game, but a few things ruined it. You got weak posture and the enemies. Everybody's holding their guns funny. It looks like such an uneven mess the way it was designed, Enemies can attack you with helicopters, bullets, grenades. And what the hell is this? Is this a fighting game or is this supposed to be like a shooting game? you know, at least give a more balanced gameplay element. So have more gunplay, more grenades, still make it a fighting game, then make it a full-out shooting action game. But no, you got to make it into this slow-paced, uneven mess. And that's what Lethal Weapon feels like. Uneven mess that goes over place. Sometimes you're fighting what looks to be like Egypt, then you're drop-kicking helicopters that can die in one hit, and you're throwing boxes at gangsters. Like, make up your mind. What type of game are you trying to give us here? It was a later Nintendo release, too, so I would expect it a lot better, but hey, movie license, so there you go. And I give it a 47 out of 100.
Yeah, I think Streets of Rage did it well with the weapons, you know, your guns and backup and all that stuff. And, I see what you're saying. Yeah, it's pretty good.
That's a good way to do gang warfare. You have excellent music, lots of variety in the weapons. You know, you got great hand-to-hand combat. Not this junk that we have here in Lethal Weapon.
Yeah. All right,
yeah,
so
you think of it and you want to play better fighting games other than it.
Yeah, like Bastion Brawler.
Well, I guess I'm the crazy one here for kind of liking this, but are you guys really surprised?
No.
Exactly.
I mean, this game is better than Backstreet Brawler, though. I'll tell you that right now.
Well, yeah, pretty much.
I mean, yeah, that's not even go over there. But anyway, then again, Wiiguy probably likes that, too. But anyway.
Like the music.
Oh, no. Anyway, that is it. We are out of here. I'm Ron Moore.
I'm the crazy Wiiguy.
Hello, I'm the indifferent video game nerd.
And that was Jay, and we're out of here. God bless. Take care.
Okay.
See ya.
I'm getting too old for this.